You're welcome to Life Changing Experience on Facebook Live. And today I'll be sharing with you something very important. God has the right door for you. You know, sometimes we pursue a vision or a dream, and maybe we experience opposition or challenges. But God wants us to know that He has right doors for us. In Revelation 3 verse 8, He said something very important. Part of what He said there. I said for you an open door. Our God is the God of the open door. And one right door from God can change your whole story or your experience. God opens doors for us to help us release a purpose, opportunities come in form of open doors. Opportunities come in form of open doors, and there are people watching me right now. Opportunities coming to you. Great opportunities coming. It doesn't matter what is happening to you financially right now. Great opportunities coming. You know, the psalmist said something. He said, "The Lord is my shepherd." He said, "I shall not want." David knew the ability of God. He knew what God can do for him. Can I say this to you? There is an opportunity with your name on it. Opportunity to manifest your purpose. Opportunity to do what God has called you to do. You know, someone can be anointed, but without the opportunity, they can manifest that anointing. David was anointed to rule, anointed to make a difference. But you know one thing that happened? David made up his mind to speak with God, even when the challenges were great. When David saw Goliath, he never saw him as a problem. He never saw Goliath as a problem. He saw Goliath as an opportunity to break forth. God has the right door for you. In this season of your life, it may seem that every door is shut and nothing is working out. Not getting the kind of return you expect from the business. But I have a word from God. God has the right door for you. And this open door will change so many things around you. It will change so many things around you. I said before, you an open door, and He said, no man can shut it. No man can shut it. No woman can shut it, because God is the one setting the door. He said, no man can shut it. This is a proof that where God is taking you to, no situation can hinder you from manifesting your greatness. God has the right door for you in this season. It doesn't matter what situation is, I can hear the sound of victory. We can feel victory in our spirits. Because God has the right door for you. In this season, you will walk through the right door. And this door is a door of multiple opportunities. Multiple opportunities. And it will be amazing. It will be amazing to you how God will lift you from one level to the other. How God is going to lift you up. God has the right door. No matter what you're going through, no matter what you're passing through, God has an opportunity with your name on it. Don't give up. Don't quit. God has the right door. Someone is watching me right now. You're asking yourself a question. What do I do about my bills? What do I do about my ministry? I need people to come help me. Maybe you're a pastor. You're watching right now. This is also a prophetic word for you. God has the right door for you. In this season, doors of opportunity will be open. Doors of preferential treatment will be open. Doors of supernatural increase will be open. Doors to do exploits will be open. Because it is a season of greater things. It is a season of greater opportunity. Expect increase. Expect things to turn out right in this season. Because God has an open door. God has an open door with your name on it. God has an open door with your name on it. Refuse to panic. Refuse to worry. Refuse to be depressed, because God has your name written on that opportunity. Your name is written on that opportunity. For that reason, never you quit. Because it is your season to testify. You know the devil can't stop you. He can't stop your health. He can't stop your finances. He can't stop your vision. He can't stop you. He said, greater is he that is in you than what is in the world. The greater one lives on our inside. If you have made Jesus the Lord of your life, he lives in you. He lives in you. He lives in you as you can live a life of dominion. Not a life of fear, not a life of worry and anxiety, but a life of victory. We are here to enforce our victory. We are here to declare who we are. And there is someone watching right now. Heaven has moved on your behalf to give you what rightly belongs to you in this season. Heaven has moved on your behalf. And things are going to move to a different dimension. Life can only get better for you. Praise the Lord. Life can only get better for you. And I hear this in my spirit. Get ready for abundance of increase. Abundance of harvest. Abundance of open door. Things you thought couldn't happen. You thought it's going to take many years, many months for you to break through, for you to succeed. God has opened the door. By faith, step into your harvest. By faith, receive this opportunity, knowing that God's word cannot fail. The word of God do not fail. The word of God cannot fail. If you trust God, you will come out strong. There is no demon in hell that can resist the power of the Word of God. No demon in hell. No witchcraft spirit can stop you from fulfilling your destiny. And this is the reason why you gotta stay in the Word. Because there is a healing in the Word. There is deliverance in the Word. There is a miracle in the Word. There is signs and wonder. The Word of God, the Bible said in Hebrews chapter 4, verse 12, it said the Word of God is quick. It said the Word of God is powerful. A lot of Christians don't know how powerful this book called the Bible is. They don't know how powerful this book, the Word, is. In Colossians 3:16, it said, let the Word of Christ dwell in you richly. If you have the Word in you richly, no opposition can contend with your future. If you have the Word in you richly, is it the Word in you equips you to live above limitation. Satan shouldn't harass you. You can harass that spirit. You can harass the evil spirit that is trying to harass you. You can bind that spirit. You can use your authority in the name of Jesus to subdue those forces that are trying to fight against you. You have authority. A lot of Christians behave like slaves. I'm sorry to say, but that's true. They behave like slaves. The devil is powerful. The devil is not powerful, I'm telling you. He's not powerful. Jesus stripped him of everything. The Bible said we have been delivered from the kingdom of darkness. We are right now in the kingdom of his dear son. The devil is not as powerful as presented in most messages in some churches. A lot of preachers talk more about the devil than they talk more about Jesus. They are more demon-minded than Christ-minded. And if you're going to experience great increase, you have to be God-minded. Because when you're God-minded, you walk in power, you walk in dominion, and you win in life. Be God-minded, not demon-minded. Be Word of God-minded. Psalm 107 verse 20, sent for his Word, and his Word healed them and delivered them. What brings the deliverance is the Word. Demons are not as powerful as most preachers present them to be. Most preachers talk about how great the devil is. I don't talk about how great the devil is. I talk about how small the devil is. And I talk about how great Jesus is. I talk about how great Jesus is. I talk about how, can you talk about how big your God is? Can you talk about how big your God is? Stop talking about how big the devil is. Talk about how big your God is. Ephesians 3 verse 20 said, now unto him that is able to do exceeding abundantly above what we think nor ask, you must surround yourself with the Word of God, listening to the Word. Create an atmosphere of God's Word. You are not the one to be oppressed by demons. You are the one to oppress demons. Demons are not expected to oppress you because you are the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. You are supposed to be in charge. You are supposed to be in charge. Jesus gave you authority. Why did Jesus die for you if he can free you from demonic powers? Why did Jesus die for you? Jesus died as you can walk in authority. Jesus died as you can walk in power. He didn't die as you can become a slave to sickness and disease, become a slave to witchcraft. No, he died as you can have a life of dominion. He said, I've come that you will have life and have it more abundantly. That is why he came. We must learn to exercise our authority. We must learn to exercise our authority over witchcraft, our authority over satanic manipulation, our authority over forces of darkness. Why? Because we are the sons of God. In John Gospel chapter 1, it said, as many that believe him, to them he gave the power to become the sons of God. Sons of God are carriers of God's power. Sons of God. Sons of God are carriers. You are carrying the power of God inside of you. No demon in hell is as powerful like you. No demon. You know why Colossians 2 verse 10 said, we are completed in him, which is the head of all principalities and power. So you shouldn't be running from the devil. The devil should be running from you. The devil should be running from you because you are carrying the life of God. You're a new creation. You're carrying the life of God. You're carrying the power of God. You are not ordinary. There is something supernatural about you. That is why I'm saying to you, God has opened the door. And you can exercise your authority. And you can walk in dominion. And you can walk in power. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Colossians chapter 2, verse 14 and 15. Always I tell people to read that scripture. Jesus made an open show of principalities and power. Nothing can hinder you when you're connected to the word of God. Nothing can hinder you. Nothing can stop your dream when you are connected to the power of God. The day Jesus came into your life was the day you were full of God's power. Power to speak, to close doors to open. You can speak to those doors that are closed to open, and you declare, in the name of Jesus, I decree that this door open. I speak that this door open. You can speak for the word of God. This centurion man in Matthew chapter 8, he said to Jesus, if you can speak the word, and my servant will be healed. The centurion man knows the power in the word. He said, speak the word. And this is what God is saying to you right now. Speak the word, and all these doors that are shut against you will open. All these financial doors, business doors, you begin to speak the word of God. The word of God travels faster than the speed of light. There is power in the word. Command the doors to be opened, the business doors. You have authority. Speak. Learn to speak the word. Speak the word. Speak the word. Speak over your finances. Command the money to come. Come on. Learn to speak in the name of Jesus. You have authority. You have authority. Speak to those doors that the enemy shut 5 years ago, 6 years ago, business doors, ministry door, relationship door. I command you, open in the name of Jesus, because you have authority. You have authority. And if you don't use your authority, it will not be used. Unused authority is not a valued authority. Unused authority is not a valued authority. So you must learn to use your authority. And when you speak in the name of Jesus, those demons will turn their back. You got power. You got the anointing. You got the name of Jesus. You got revelation of his will. Hallelujah. You got authority. Use your authority. He said, in my name you will cast out devils. He didn't say you will negotiate with the devils. We're not here to negotiate with demons. We're here to ask them to get out. You cast the devil out, not negotiate with the devil. You don't beg demons. You don't beg the devil. You exercise authority over the spirit. The apostles came back and said, the devils were subject to us. They exercised the authority that Jesus gave to them. Nothing can stop your financial future. Nothing can stop your financial destiny. nothing against of it. You have authority in the name of Jesus to speak to this situation and to command this situation to stop. You have authority to speak to the businesses to open up, to speak to the companies to connect with you. You have authority to speak that the doors will be open. You have to use your authority. God will not use the authority for you. Jesus will not use the authority for you. You have to use your authority. You have to use your right in Christ Jesus to open the doors. No demon can stand the name of Jesus. That name is so powerful. That name is so great. You're watching me right now. And God is saying, use your authority. Speak to your finances. Speak to your finances. Stop crying about your finances. Stop complaining about your finances. Stop worrying about your finances and start speaking over it. Speak over it. In the name of Jesus, I call forth finances. I call forth resources. You begin to speak the word of God. You speak God's word with an expectation to see a change. You speak God's word with an expectation to see healing and miracles. You speak God's word with an expectation to see provision. You speak God's word with an expectation to see signs and wonders. You speak God's word with an expectation to see transformation. So whenever you're speaking the word of God, you need to have an expectation that what you're saying will come to pass. What you're saying will come to pass because there is power in the word. There is deliverance in the word. There is signs and wonder in the word. Psalm 107 verse 20, he sent forth his word. The word went forth. And when the word went forth, the next thing we saw was he healed them and delivered them from their destruction. So it is the word that heals. It is the word of God that delivers. And it is the word of God that sets free. It is the word of God that heals. It is the word of God that delivers. It is God's word that sets free. God has the right door for you. In this season, I want you to expect miracles. I want you to expect healing. I want you to expect restoration. Everything is going to be all right. I'm praying for you right now that every expectation, every heart desire, every dream in your heart is going to be all right. It's going to be all right. Miracles happen when we speak God's word by faith. Miracles happen when we speak God's word by faith. Miracles happen when we speak God's word by faith. Because when you walk by faith, you break limitation. When you walk by faith, you prosper. When you walk by faith, you see signs and wonders. And the scripture said the just shall live by his faith. And faith is a product of God's word. Faith is a product of God's word. And the word of God is coming to us right now. The just shall live by his faith. Speak over your situation. Ezekiel 37. In Ezekiel 37, the bones were dry. And the word of the Lord came to Ezekiel. He said, can these bones live? And he said, thou knowest the Lord. Ezekiel 37. And he said, prophesy. You got to prophesy. You got to speak forth. And then command the doors to be open. Then command the healing to take place. Command the deliverance to happen. Because you have authority. Because God has set before you an open door. Miracles happen in the name of Jesus. There is healing in the name. There is deliverance in the name. There is signs and wonder in the name. There is encounter in the name of Jesus. And signs and wonder happen when we walk by faith. There is someone watching this broadcast right now. God is telling you this is a confirmation to what I told you. Speak the word. Stop weeping. Stop crying. Stop worrying and start declaring. Stop. Don't accept the defeat. Declare the dominion. Declare the dominion. All the reports before you is subject to change. All the reports before you is subject to change, whether they're emotional reports, their financial reports, their spiritual reports, all the reports before you is subject to change. And right now in the name of Jesus, I prophesy to you, that every situation before you bow in the name of Jesus. Every situation that looked like a storm that has been challenging you, I come in agreement with my faith with yours. Right now, we'll demand a change in the name of Jesus. We'll demand a miracle of transformation. A miracle of divine transformation that will begin to happen right now. Let the miracle begin to happen right now. Miracle of provision. Miracle of wealth transfer. That home will be paid in full. Someone, you're battling with some immigration issues. I pray for supernatural intervention concerning your immigration issues. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Miracles are happening right now. The visa will be approved. Someone needs a visa to travel. I hear the Lord saying, you have the visa. The visa. You have the visa. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Miracles are happening right now. I feel that anointing that heals is upon you, 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 is upon you. Receive right now. Receive visitation from heaven. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Glory be to God. If you're watching this broadcast and you've not known Jesus as your Lord and Savior, you can say this after me. Lord Jesus, I confess with my mouth, I believe in my heart that God have raised Jesus from the dead. Thank you, Father, for saving me. Amen. If you pray that prayer with us, you're born again. You can look for Bible Believing Church where you can worship and grow in your faith with God. And you can subscribe to our YouTube channel, It's Faithman Teaching on YouTube. And you have opportunity to listen to more than 400 videos that will change your way of thinking and empower you to take the lead. We love you until our next broadcast. Don't forget there is greatness in you. We're going to be right back today and expect better things. We're going for a conference right now on Periscope, Kingdom Empowerment Conference. So if you follow us on Periscope, you can join us on Periscope for a live conference and your life will never remain the same. Love you. Prophet, thank you for your heart and your hands. God bless you.